frontside 50-50s on transition. Compared to backside, it is often strangely difficult. But once you understand the physics behind it, you'll see that it's actually much easier to approach. The first key point, if you keep your weight inside the ramp and have your weight on the heel side of your back truck, there's no logical reason that you hang on the coping. The second point, when locking in, keep on extending your body toward the inside of the ramp until the heel side of your back truck locks in completely. Keep these in mind, and let's break down the mechanics in detail. You're watching Why the Trek, please subscribe. One big reason rolling back in feels so hard is that you can't see the bottom of the transition while grinding. If you feel unsafe or unstable, it is natural to hunch forward. You may even grab something in front of you to avoid falling backward. Plus, during the trek, the deck of the ramp appears right in front of your face, which may make you hunch even more. The problem is, when you hunch forward, the center of mass also shifts forward. If you try to come back in from this state, your body rotates around the line connecting your center of mass and a back toe-side wheel. With this, the back truck can't get over the coping and gets stuck. In other words, as long as the weight is on the toe side, you can't come back in. So what's the fix? The most important thing is that if your center of mass stays inside the ramp, and your weight is over the heel side of the back truck, your body will then rotate around the line that connects these points. Then, the toe side wheel naturally clears the coping, making it physically impossible for the back truck to get caught. The toe side wheel may touch the coping, but as long as your weight is on the heel side, you can roll back in without any problem. Another factor that makes a trick feel harder is the difference between frontside 50-50s on ledges and transitions. In a ledge frontside 50-50, you can usually stay centered over the deck, grind straight, and you can come off the grind easily. But in transition, your center mass upon coming out of the grind is much farther inside the ramp and lower compared to that on a ledge. This difference is what throws people off. That said, here's a way to get used to the feeling of coming off the grind. Place your board on the coping, so both trucks' heel sides are touching the coping. Start leaning back, so you will bring your body weight back to the inside of the ramp. Add a slight shoulder rotation, and you'll be able to come back in. If you feel unsafe, step off the board as soon as possible. In order to fight the fear of rolling back in, experiment with where you look. Some skaters find it helpful to look at the back truck. That way they can visually confirm that toe side wheels clear the coping, which lowers the risk of hanging up. While others may feel safer when they can see the direction they'll be heading. To do this, you do not need to twist your upper body all the way 180 degrees. Just lower your front arm and glance right beside it, and you'll naturally see the way forward. Remember, keep your center of mass inside the ramp, and lock with your back heel. If you do both, there is no logical way that you will hang up with or without being able to see it. Once you are comfortable with rolling back in, the earlier parts of the trek should feel much safer. Now let's look at the motion of locking in. When locking in, a frequent issue is that while the back truck locks in, the front truck stops on the deck of the ramp. Or you may also lock in with the toe sides with both trucks. Since your weight is inside the ramp during the trek, standing on your toes will tip the board, and you won't be able to hold the grind. most of these problems can be solved by proper pumping. As you ride up the ramp, pump a bit harder right before the coping. Envision the place you want to be, just like the practice that you did on the coping. Push your body upward and inward toward that spot, stretching into the ramp as you pump. There is a force pushing your body outward away from the ramp, which naturally makes you tip forward even if you don't do anything. Pump to counteract that force and bring your body into the right spot. Keep pumping until the heelside wheel of the back truck catches the coping. The body will try to shoot outward, but the heelside wheel holds it in place. Once you're fully extended, set the front truck on the coping and enjoy the grind. Ideally, you want both trucks locked on the heelside. But as long as the back truck's heelside is locked on the coping, you don't have to worry too much about the front truck, and you can still grind. While grinding, avoid leaning over the toe side and keep your weight on the heelside the whole time. Also, please try the WiderTrex motion tracking system. You can visualize the motion of your body parts and simulate it in the 3D environment. Please give me your feedback. And that's all for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time.